we suspect the patient has a lumbar problem. So part of the examination, of course, is a straight leg raise test. And let's imagine we do the test, and at a certain moment the patient has pain, for instance in the gluteal area, and there is some limitation of movement. Okay. But immediately after the straight leg raise, we always perform the passive hip flexion. And what do we find now? That the passive hip flexion is more limited than the straight leg raise. This is an important red flag. Because when the passive hip flexion is more limited than the straight leg raise, we can exclude with certainty discodural conflicts or discoradicular conflicts. We have to look for the reason of the problem somewhere else. During the lumbar examination or the hip examination, we found a sign of the buttock. Remember, hip flexion is more limited than straight leg raise. So this is a red flag. A moral of the story, we need medical imaging to be on the safe side. We have to check some differential diagnostic options. And which are the options? It could be an infections problem, a cancer problem, or a fracture problem. Yeah? When you talk about infection, osteomyelitis, a septic arthritis, an abscess, a neoplasm, or even a fracture is also a possibility. So anyhow, medical imaging is called for.